Hi viewer, I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies form 2, lesson number 7. The topic is forms of business unit. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson objectives. Discuss the cooperatives as a form of business unit. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to write what is a cooperative, how is it organized, how is it managed, and even the advantages and disadvantages. An introduction to cooperative. A cooperative society is a group of people who come together mainly to provide convenient and efficient services to members and eliminate middlemen so that profits go to the members. So all those organizations where now we have group of people coming together, for example, when we talk about the dairy cooperative societies, this one they deal with milk. They are people, members who are from within a certain region, a certain area, who have come up together, and their purpose is to eliminate the services to eliminate the middlemen who are buying milk from the farmers. They bring the farmers together, where now the farmers are supposed to collect their milk together and sell it as a society. And this one now it is to ensure that the profit goes back to the members. It is usually formed by people with common problems or common interests. For example, when we talk about the dairy farmers, it means that their interest it is selling milk. So in that case, now they have a common interest or a common problem. They need to get market for their products. What are the principles of cooperatives? Now, for a cooperative to start, there are the principles of cooperatives that are supposed to first of all be met. Now, according to Rock Dyer, pioneer in Britain, in 1844, is the one who started or who looked about the modern cooperations, or who started it. These principles are voluntary and open membership. This is a point where the farmer or the member has a free will, either to choose to join or even to leave the cooperative. It is voluntary. It is open. Anytime, any day, when you feel to join that cooperative, according to the Rock Dyer, you are free to join. Number 2, democratic administration. That means there is the selection. It is democratic administered. It is democratic managed. The administration there, it is democratic. That means the members are the ones to choose. They are the ones to just decide who is going to lead them, who is going to manage them, who is going to be the manager. Number 3, limited interest on share capital. So, the interest they get, it is the dividends. This one, it is behind the shares. How many shares do you have? That is now, when it comes to getting the interest, you get as a dividends to the shares. Number 4, it is the cooperation with other cooperatives. They must be able to cooperate with other cooperatives. This is a point where you get that we have unions that are a point point where now we have more than one cooperative cooperating together and then making the unions. So they should be able to cooperate, more than one cooperative. Number five, promotion of education to the members. So the cooperative is responsible for offering educational services, advisory services to its members. Number six, provision of dividends to the members. This is every year, there is that profit interest that the company gets. It's supposed to be divided according to the shares. That is what you are referring to it as dividends. The principles, you can be able to see voluntary and open membership. You are free to join anytime. Democratic membership, meaning that there is a free will to give your decision. And then it should be, there should be some agreement. Then membership, economic participation, autonomy and independence, education, training and information, cooperative among other cooperatives, and concern for community. Ownership. Cooperative societies are owned by at least 10 adults. That means they should be above 18 years, who register as members on payment of non-refundable membership fee. So 10 of them are ready to start the business, but addition of others later on. Members not around to own more than 5% of the shares of the total share capital of the society. Then members have limited liability, meaning that even if the cooperative is not able to repay its debts, then members' assets are not interfered with. Assignment. Discuss the principles of the cooperatives. That is the assignment for today, activity. You discuss the principles of cooperatives. For reference, you can visit KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, that edition. If I tell you off, you need to come get us. You can get us through the SMS, you SMS to that number. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook. And also, you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Erin TV. Thank you.